The worst year ever? Yeah, that's 2020. Done. End of video. You can all go home now. I need a goddamn drink.
You're coming back, right?
So the best way I can describe 2020 is that the higher powers are running a free trial of every apocalypse scenario imaginable all at once, but no decision has been made yet about which will be the definitive choice to end us all. What's the matter, buddy? You ran out of f***ing locusts? 2020 has been a ride, and I have no doubt this particular year is gonna stick in humanity's collective memory as one of the craziest times ever. Silver linings this year have been sparse, and then on the rare occasion when we do get one, 2020 sneaks up behind you and dumps a bag of spiders over your head. Metaphorical bag of spiders aside, I do take some solace in the fact that scientists and historians aren't coming out to declare, yep, 2020 is scientifically the worst year ever. We've hit rock f***ing bottom, manifested a large shovel, and somehow continued to dig. Unlike the unfortunate topic of today's video. I'm Vibby, and on this episode of A Space Alien Explains, 536 AD. Yes, both scientists and historians have objectively declared 536 AD to be the worst time to be alive. Here's why. It all started one morning when a peasant rolled himself out of bed, opened his windows, and shouted what I assume could only be, "Jesus f***, what happened to the sun?" Actually, that's not written down in any historical accounts, but come on, somebody definitely said it. A mysterious, incredibly dense fog had rolled in practically overnight, covering Europe, the Middle East, and parts of Asia, plunging everything it touched into complete darkness. A Byzantine historian described the situation like this: "The sun gave forth its light without brightness, and it seemed exceedingly like the sun in eclipse, for the beams it shed were not clear." Or in other words, bro, it's 2 in the goddamn afternoon and holy shit, it's f***ing dark out here. The fog would remain 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, for the next 18 months. As you would guess, an apocalyptic fog that's dense enough to block out the sun for so long wouldn't spell anything good for the inhabitants of planet Earth. Global temperatures plummeted and a conga line of pain ensued. China reported seeing snow in the summertime. Peru was afflicted with drought. The dropping temperatures resulted in crop failures across Europe, Asia, and Africa. Documents in Ireland mention a failure of bread. Get bread trees. It's not just the bread trees that got economy got from the lack of crops, and the widespread famines meant a lot of people's lives got as in they died. Just to make sure we're talking about the right kind of here. So let's say you make it to the other side of 536. You got through a year of no sun, no food, and an economy gone to basically, we're at rock bottom. No way the next few years can get any worse, right? Time to get your shovel and start digging. Hardship intensified a thousandfold in 541, when an outbreak of bubonic plague wiped out close to 100 million people and half of the Byzantine Empire. You'll probably recognize this particular outbreak as the Plague of Justinian, which lasted until around 549. Fast forward to the 21st century. A historian and a scientist are asking themselves, "Look, man, mysterious dense fogs responsible for a conga line of trauma don't just come completely out of butt nowhere. Something had to have caused it." And they managed to find that answer only a couple of years ago. A research team led by medieval historian Michael McCormick and glaciologist Paul Majewski found evidence from a Swiss glacier that a catastrophic volcanic eruption might have been the source of the fog. Some volcano in Iceland decided it couldn't take this shit anymore and decided to take everyone in the world down with it. Pretty much anytime there's a sudden massive global climate drop, it can be traced back to some volcano having a bad time. The research team also found that there may have been other eruptions in 540 and 547, which likely did nothing to help the plague situation in Europe. First it's dark as sh**, then it's cold as sh**, and now there ain't to eat, and also the mountains keep exploding. What's this weird blister on my lymph nodes? Anyway, hope this makes you feel a little better about 2020. I mean, it probably didn't, but eh, I tried. Also, there's still a month left, and anything could happen. Speaking of which, has anybody been keeping an eye on Yellowstone? So before I close out this video, I just wanted to address the elephant in the room, which is how inaccurate my channel banner is. I am still working on the 10K video, but 2020's been kicking my ass. stopped and I ended up taking an unannounced break from YouTube to focus on other important things and try to get some of my creative energy back. If you follow me on Twitter or Instagram, you probably saw the month-long art series I did during October, and it actually did help me out a lot. So yes, 10K vid is still coming. I just gotta sort out some other stuff before I can get there. The other major thing that helped me come back was the support of my lovely patrons, who are the ones that chose the topic for this video. My Patreon is still in the early stages, but if you want to join anyway, I'll put a link in the corner and in the description. Shoutouts to my honorary aliens Abu Kitty Chris and Poppy00. Stick around to the end of the video to see who else out there is also an honorary alien. Anyway, going back to work on that 10K video.
What if you jinxed it and Yellowstone does explode?
Don't try to threaten me with a good time, Pask. Hi everyone, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this episode. This week's featured fan art is by PoppyPops11 on Twitter. Link to the artist's page is in the description. And here's some comments from the last video. If you enjoyed this episode, please be sure to drop a like and hit that subscribe button if you want to see more content like this. If you'd like to support the channel, links to my Patreon, Ko-fi page, and art commission info are in the description. Follow me on my Twitter and Instagram at Taya Ozaida for art and channel updates. Thank you so much again for watching, and here come the honorary aliens.